Congressman, good to see you, sir.
Oh, I'm glad you can see me, Liz. I was worried I might be invisible to you and your viewers, because for a while I've been invisible to some folks on Twitter who are trying to search for me, apparently because I'm an outspoken conservative.
Right, apparently because Twitter algorithm detected your tweets and marked them as some sort of, quote, troll-like behavior. We checked your account to see if it dropped down for us, and it did not. How did you figure out this was happening to you?
Well, I only figured it out when a reporter reached out to me, and it was not from a right-wing media outlet. It was actually from a left-wing media outlet, but they were searching for different members of Congress, and they found that four of us received this discriminatory impact from Twitter. And it was, as you said, myself, Jim Jordan, Mark Meadows, and Devin Nunes. Twitter claims that this is an inadvertent glitch, but if an inadvertent glitch catches four of the most outspoken conservatives in the Congress, it certainly raises a lot of questions. Also, just last week, Liz, I was grilling Twitter executives before the Judiciary Committee about their bias, and then the very next week, I learn of this shadow ban. Look, you know, I'm a libertarian-leaning conservative just like you are. I don't want the government to be excessively entangled in the work of private companies, but it's really important for your viewers to understand that Twitter gets liability protections from the federal government because they're a neutral platform. They say that because we're a public forum, we get to dismiss certain types of lawsuits. So you can't, on one hand, get rid of lawsuits because you're neutral, and then on the other hand, engage in this discriminatory conduct against conservative speakers.
Want to see more videos like this? Click on the link below and subscribe to One America News on YouTube, and call your cable provider and kindly demand that One America News is added to your lineup. Call and subscribe today.